Floyd Shivambo says we are taking everything, right? He's talking about things that are going to happen during this by-election, because yeah, we are in the mood of a by-election. Now let's proceed a bit further here. John Steenhuisen comment about he's going to improve the working conditions. Now, wait a minute. Bongana, you're saying John Steenhuisen, he's going to comment about he's going to improve the condition of farm workers. Yes, I said it. But you're going to say, but Bongs, where was he all along? There was this issue that was happening in front of us. Where was he? Well, I am as clueless as you. I don't understand where the man was. I don't understand why hasn't he said anything. But he's telling us that he's going to comment about it. There's another thing that I also find very interesting here. It's the issue of the ZCC gospel singer. I want us to talk about that person for a moment. There's something very interesting that I want us to talk about here. Solim Moholo has been hospitalized and they are trying to raise $700,000 for him to undergo brain surgery. Yes, brain surgery. We'll talk about that. We will need to talk about as well former president of the Republic of South Africa, Mr. Thabo Mbeki. Let's talk more action, and you know what I'm saying? He says that's how we're going to regain this. Duma in KZN, this is what he said. And I'm going to talk about this now so that when they fail to do it, and then we'll refer back to this video. Duma says, ANC has no excuse but to deliver service to communities, says Uduma. So we'll talk about those things and more. But Paul Mashatile as well speak about the fact that, hey, you shoot police. Police have got they don't have this thing of tolerance. They have got low tolerance to people who are shooting or killing police. They are going to deal with you accordingly. You use excessive force against them, definitely they are going to use excessive force against you. Okay, give me time. Lend me your ears. Let me give you the stories. Before we can successfully do that, this is what I want you to do here. If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge. And that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contribution to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel. And you know what I'm saying? We'll bring you more. And also, guys, want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed. Okay. Let's start here. Paul Mashatile says, Paul Mashatile Uti, why am I losing Paul Mashatile here? Utige. So you can't shoot someone after you have died. So you have to understand the situation you are in. These criminals are very clear. They are killing. So what are we still analyzing? We train you, we give you guns, use them. I just wanna read that part alone. This is the verse. Uti, you can't shoot someone after you have died. That statement. In other words, prevent dying. Right? Then it goes on to say, so you have to understand the situation you are in. These criminals are very clear that they are killing. So what are we still analyzing? We trained you. We gave you guns. Use them. Oh, my God. The message is clear. What's your take, Wena? But for me, Vele, I kind of feel like, why, Vele, we can't, I'm with police here. If criminals are using excessive forces, then meet them. You know what I'm saying? Let the ground be fair. Let the ground be evil. Even. You know, let the ground be equal. Meet them, you know what I'm saying, accordingly. Excessive force versus excessive force. Now let's move on to Solimoholo. There's something that I don't understand about the situation. It was posted that Solimoholo's management team, we just want to update you as his fans regarding Solimoholo's recent hospitalization. The letter below is written on behalf of the family of Solimoholo's legal representation with the accompanying banking details of those who will like to contribute towards his medical bills, right? Then you get the letter goes on and on and on. But what we know as a matter of fact is he needs about 700K. That's close to R1 million, because it's only 300,000 away from R1 million for that to happen. The reason I even thought of this and I said to myself, wait, I want to talk about this. I want to talk about the roles of churches. And what I'm going to say, it's not necessarily an attack to the ZCC church. Even the church I go to, till these days, the questions I've sent to them, I've never gotten a response. During COVID-19, these people were sitting with millions. I'm talking about my church. But I've never seen them helping us on the ground. Yes, I've heard about one or two people being donated to, but yay, when they want money, they don't go to one or two people and say, give us money. They go to all of us. But when it comes to helping us, it's just one or two people. Then why must we be faithful to such organizations? Now, I'm saying this to say, we haven't heard what his church has done towards maybe contributing towards his medical bill. You know what I'm saying? I'm saying the church can't be, it cannot be that the church just receives, and they don't contribute to the human beings who are giving them money or donating, whatever it is, offerings, tithe, whatever money you are giving them. Why is it that our organizations doesn't take care of us, including my organization? And I will not lie to you and say, if anything were to happen to me, my organization will help me. I'm talking about church when I say organization. That's what I'm saying. I think it's about time we have a real conversation about our churches, right? It's about time. Why are we useful as long as we give them money? But when we have problem, then they will come and pray for us. When a pastor needs something, hi, Basalan, they don't say, let's collect money. They don't say, hey, Basalan, let's pray for the pastor to get them. They say, hey, dig deep into your pocket. But then there's a child who needs money to go to school. Guess what churches used to look, they usually do to us? Let's pray for him. God will help. Oh, when it is somebody else, God must find other miraculous way to help. But when it is somebody, when it's a pastor, we must dig deep to our pocket. I'm saying it's about time we introspect about our churches, right? It's about time where we introspect about our religion, the religion we are in. Let's continue to talk about Thabo Mbeki. Thabo Mbeki says, Thabo Mbeki, they need more actions, right? Let's say, to regain voter support, we must move from talk to action. As a province, we need to be judged by what we do, not just by what we say. The very important part of winning back the support of the population, which is the last election removed away from the ANC, to win them back, that support is going to depend on what we do, not what we say. I'm glad they understand that as early as they can, right? I'm seriously glad about it. The ANC in KZN, the ANC has no excuse but to deliver, says Uduma. So echoed the same sentiment. Uti, there's no excuse whatsoever that we must not deliver. We must deliver because people are looking for new opportunities on the issue of unemployment and the issue of infrastructure development, says Uduma, right? Which I think I agree with him. I fully agree. I fully concur with him. Now, here is another hypocrite that I'm about to talk about here. This hypocrite says, Minister of Agriculture John Steenhuisen has vowed to improve the working conditions of veterinarians in South Africa, right? Okay, let's look at this one. He says, animal health practitioners play a huge role in safeguarding the country's agricultural sector, animal health, biosecurity, and food security. It's called veterinarian, that word, a cornerstone of South African agriculture success. And without addressing the systematic issue they face, we risk jeopardizing not only their well-being, but the national food security. Now we're about to get into the one of Floyd Chivambo, but I thought we need to talk about this because the minister he knows about the conditions of people who are working in agriculture, which, by the way, in this department, usually it's dominated by white people. He knows about how that conditions need to be improved, but he doesn't know about the condition or the working conditions of black people who are working for these people. He doesn't know his mom towards that. He's quiet about that. And is that a coincidence? That's the DA for you. I'm asking you guys, is that a coincidence? Because he's very mum about that. He hasn't said anything, right? Yet he knows about the working conditions of those doctors, animal doctors. He knows about it. He wants to address it. What about the two black females that were killed by white farmers and were body fed to pigs? Is that not a condition worth of noting and rectifying? Is that not worth of your time? Because for me, that constitutes a working condition. Why do you seem to be caring about the working conditions of these the doctors, but you don't care about the black people who are working for these farmers as well? Why is it that it is security, food security, blah 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 blah, when it comes to this other spectrum, but on the other spectrum, you don't care? Is it because the people who are working, who are a working class there, their skin is different? You see, they haven't said anything, but now they are telling us that how they need to improve conditions. Oh, Floyd Chivambo. Oh, to Floyd Chivambo, we want to send a very strong warning to all corners of South Africa that when it comes to elections, we are taking everything. We are going to win all the wards here in KwaZulu-Natal, take over the municipalities, says Floyd Chivambo. Okay? And I need to repeat this warning. He said, we want to send a very strong warning to all corners of South Africa that when it comes to elections, we are taking everything. We are going to win all the wards here in KZN and take over all the municipalities. Akushongoke mina guys, ningangibuzi nje ningathi mina ngithe uFloyd Chivambo uthe. Angishongo ukuthi ubongani uthe ngithe uFloyd Chivambo uthe. UFloyd Chivambo usitshela ukuthi nangula onenkinga axhumane noFloyd Chivambo, not mina. ozoluza axhumane no Floyd Shivambo hayi mina nangisho ukuthi Floyd Shivambo akwatisa abantu bakhale bathi yi awusengisebenze kangaka ngingalali ngifida abantu hawa bogogo base what when there's a problem of what 93 ningangifaki mina mina ngitshela ukuthi Floyd Shivambo uthe blame ano Floyd Shivambo ke hayi mina kiphani mina lami igama nilikhiphi yabona nje lobo gogo base what 93 nje ngiyabacela ngithi mina hey ngomoya omuhle ningalifake lami igama lapha. I'll see you guys on the next video.